Venn diagrams. We'll see how to shade Venn diagrams. For shading A union B, we have to shade the circle A plus the circle B. So this will be A union B. Suppose if you need to shade A intersection B, we just shade out only the common region of the two circles. That is, if you have circle A and circle B, this is A and this is B, then we shade the common region. This will be A intersection B. Suppose if we have to shade A complement, A complement is nothing but we just leave out the set A and shade all the rest of it. That is called as A complement. So this is the circle A and then we shade everything else other than the circle A. So that will give us a complement. In the same way, if we need to shade B complement, we just leave out circle B alone and shade the rest of the circle B. Even the common region, if it is, that is not a problem. That is, the circle B alone we leave and shade the rest of it, that is called as B complement. Suppose if you need to shade A union B complement, in that case, we need to see wherever it is shaded in A complement and wherever it is shaded in B complement. This is the figure for A complement. So only circle A is left out. And this is the figure for B complement. Only circle B is left out. Where is it shaded in both the diagrams? The part which is not shaded in both the diagrams is the common region. If you take here, this is shaded. But here, this part is shaded, though it's not shaded. So only the common region we leave and all the rest of the diagram we shaded. That is called as A complement union B complement. In the same way, suppose if it is A complement intersection B complement, that means wherever it is the common region for both the figures, we need to check both the figures, where does it have common? That is, this outside part is shaded in this figure as well as in this figure. So A complement intersection B complement will be the outside region. So when it is like this combinations, it's always better to draw a separate diagram and then do it. Then it makes the work easy. Suppose if you have a diagram like this, these two are disjoint sets. That is, they are not in connection with each other. In this, if you need to find A union B, you shade the circle A, then we shade the circle B. This is A union B. Then intersection B, suppose if you need to find A intersection B, there is nothing in common between A and B, so it is a null set. Suppose if you have a set like this with A and B, that is, here we have the circle A, and then which is a subset, B is a subset. In this case, if you need to find A union B, A and B, we have to combine both. So wherever there is an A, we shade it. So automatically it becomes the complete A. For this, if you need to find an intersection of the set, A and then it is a B. The common element, common region for A intersection B, that is only B. So this is the common region. So this will be the common region for A and B. So it is A intersection B is only B. In this diagram, if we need to shade A intersection B complement, A intersection B complement, B complement is we leave out B. All the rest of the outside B is B complement and intersect it with A. So this will be the region A intersection B complement. Suppose if you have three sets A, B and C, if you need to shade A union B union C, wherever it is shaded in A and B and C, you have to just do it. So this will be A union B union C. So wherever there is a circle A, circle B, circle C, we shade it. That is called as A union B union C. The same thing, suppose if you are doing A intersection B intersection C, that is the common region for all the three sets we need to shade. So when we take, this is the common region. So this is the common region, so we shade this region. So this will be A intersection B intersection C. Suppose if you are asked to say shade A union B complement intersection C. If it is a question like this, it's always better to do in parts. That is, we'll just draw the diagram, maybe a rough diagram you can draw, and just shade first which is A. Like this we have, now this is A, B and a C. So now when we are finding A, A alone is, this is A. And then we'll do for B complement. B complement will be, we'll have the B alone, we leave all the rest of it, we shaded, that will be B complement. So the circle B alone we are leaving and we are shading all the other part. Till here is circle B. So we'll shade all the rest of it. So now A union B complement we need to do first. A union B complement. So union is wherever it is shaded in both the diagrams, you need to shade it. So now when you take here, A is shaded. And this part here, see, this part is not shaded, but it is shaded in this diagram. So we leave out that circle B, but in this, the common region is over here, it is shaded. Here also it is shaded. So we'll just shade this, only this part of it we'll not shade. So that is, this part alone we'll not shade. All the rest of it we'll shade it. So this will be A union B complement. Now we need to intersect it with C. This diagram, where is it common region with C? So now when you take here, this is only C. When we intersect it with C, so it is only C. So we have our last diagram as A union B complement intersection C. So will be, when you intersect it, this one is there and then the circle C, so everything. This will be the answer for A union B complement intersection C. So it's always better to do it part by part so that you don't go wrong. Now if you are given with these two Venn diagrams, we need to write the symbol for this Venn diagrams. In order to do that, here the shape which is not shaded is A union B union C. Outside part, opposite of it, we need to write. So it will be A union B union C, the whole complement. For this one, when you take this A union B, B union C is shaded, and then it is A union B union C, the whole complement means even this part will be shaded. So it will be, first let us write for this, that will be A union B. So we have shaded that A union B, and then if you take the circle C, all the outside of the circle is shaded, so we can have it as C complement. And if you write a union, that is A union B is all this part and then the complement of it. So we are left out only with this part. So thus we can draw the Venn diagrams as well as write the notations for the Venn diagrams. Thank you.